Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science here, and I have my plant jacket on, which means it's time to talk about antioxidants. You'll hear words like antioxidant, oxidative stress, free radicals, and reactive oxygen species thrown around all the time. In skincare, in diet, in supplements, in shampoo. What do they all mean? You've come to the right place to find out. One of the key ways in which your body ages is through oxidative stress, which is a fancy way of saying free radical damage. Free radicals are substances, molecules or atoms, with an unpaired electron. Electrons like to be paired up, so free radicals are really reactive. They really want to get an extra electron and get a pair. They're so unstable that they'll take an electron from anything that's around to become more stable. When a free radical takes an electron, the substance that loses the electron to the free radical becomes oxidized, which is why it's called oxidative stress. The substance that lost the electron used to have an even number, so now it has an unpaired electron, so now it's really reactive, and will take another electron from another substance, and so on and so forth. We now have a chain reaction. A lot of the free radicals in living organisms contain oxygen, and so they're often called reactive oxygen species, or ROS. The most common free radicals in humans are superoxide and hydroxyl. Stealing electrons might not sound too bad, but in the process, you have breaking and making of chemical bonds, which causes irreversible changes in the substance's structure and function. If you want these processes to occur, then it's a good thing. Free radicals are useful and in fact essential to lots of things, like free radical polymerization, which is used to make most of the plastics that we use today. They're also important in lots of biological processes. Free radicals are also the reason that benzoyl peroxide acne cream works to kill acne bacteria. But if free radicals form in the wrong place at the wrong time, then they'll react with whatever's around. In the skin, that means they'll react with important substances like DNA, proteins, and lipids. And these chain reactions will cause a lot of microscopic damage that's eventually reflected when you see your skin, like wrinkles, fine lines, thinning skin, pigmentation, and even cancer. Free radicals can also trigger inflammation and other pathways in your skin that lead to damage, like increasing the amount of matrix metalloproteinases, or MMPs, which are enzymes that break down collagen in your skin. The collagen that makes your skin plump and bouncy. So now we know that free radicals are harmful, where do they come from? Free radicals are formed during normal biological processes like respiration, where oxygen is used to break down food to give our bodies energy. These are unavoidable. But environmental factors like UV light from the sun, pollution, and smoking can cause more free radicals to form in your body, and these will all affect your skin. In your skin, UV is particularly bad. Free radicals form in your skin within around 15 minutes of UV exposure, and they'll keep on being produced for up to an hour afterwards. Both UVA and UVB can cause free radical formation. UVA penetrates deeper into your skin, so it can cause deeper damage. How can we reduce free radical damage? Obviously, we can avoid these environmental factors. We can stop smoking, and we can reduce pollution in our cities. To avoid UV, we can stay in the shade, or we can cover up our skin with sunscreen and clothing. But we can also prevent free radical damage after they've been formed, and here's where antioxidants come in. An antioxidant is a substance that can neutralise free radicals. They're usually substances that are pretty stable with an unpaired electron, and so once the free radical takes their electron, the chain reaction will stop. Essentially, antioxidants are like sacrificial shields or sponges that intercept the free radicals before they have a chance to react with more important biological molecules. Your body naturally contains antioxidants that can soak up these free radicals. There are antioxidant enzymes like superoxide dismutase, catalase, and glutathione peroxidase. There are also smaller antioxidants like vitamin C and E, coenzyme Q10, which is also known as ubiquinone, and glutathione. However, these natural antioxidant systems that our bodies have evolved over time can get overwhelmed if there are just way too many free radicals. That's why a lot of people try to supplement their bodies with extra antioxidants, from so-called superfoods, supplements, and skincare. It's debatable whether antioxidant supplements actually help. Clinical studies have gone both ways on this, probably because it's hard to control where the antioxidants actually go in your body, so they can even do things like help keep unwanted cells, like cancer cells, alive. Luckily, a lot of food that's healthy for other reasons, like vegetables and fruit, are high in antioxidants anyway. In terms of skincare, it's a lot less complicated. Since your skin is on your outside, it's a part of your body that gets a lot of exposure to environmental sources of free radicals, especially UV radiation from the sun. So it's one of the parts of your body that can benefit a lot from the extra antioxidants. There are a lot of antioxidants in skincare products, but not all of them have studies to back them up. Like with any other skincare ingredient, whether or not the antioxidants actually help depends on whether or not they can get to the right place to work. Here are some antioxidants that have studies to back them up. Superoxide dismutase and catalase. These are antioxidant enzymes that are naturally present in your skin. Catalase is also promising for helping prevent grey hair. Vitamin C or ascorbic acid. Your cells are made of a watery inside, the intracellular fluid, surrounded by an oily cell membrane. And in between the separate cells, there's also more watery liquid called extracellular fluid. Vitamin C is water-soluble, so it's naturally found inside these watery compartments, the intracellular and extracellular fluid, to help protect you from free radicals. Vitamin C is also important for making collagen and works to reduce pigmentation, so it's a really good ingredient for aging and hyperpigmentation-prone skin. I've talked about it before in my video on treating post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. Pure ascorbic acid is the version that has the most proven benefits, especially when we're talking about antioxidant effects, but the esters can potentially work this way as well. Vitamin E is vitamin C's oil-soluble counterpart, and it's also naturally found in your body in the oily parts, like the cell membranes. Coenzyme Q10 or ubiquinone is an antioxidant that's also important in energy production. Its levels decline with age, and it's a popular supplement for heart health, even though it's uncertain whether or not it's actually effective. You can also use antioxidants that you don't normally find in your body, like plant antioxidants. Many plants have evolved to have potent antioxidants in them to help protect them from UV, since they're exposed to a lot more UV than organisms that can stand up and walk out of the sun. Some examples of plant antioxidants are polyphenols, flavonoids, isoflavones, and anthocyanins. Some of the antioxidants that you'll find in skincare that have some studies to support them are ferulic acid, which comes from cereal and is great at keeping vitamin C and E stable. You'll find the three ingredients combined in a lot of products like SkinCeutical CE Ferulic and Paula's Choice Vitamin C Serum. Green tea polyphenols are potent antioxidants, especially epigallocatechin 3 gallate, which has somewhere between 25 and 100 times the antioxidant ability compared to vitamin C and E. There are other antioxidant polyphenols in tea as well, like epicatechin, epicatechin 3 gallate, and epigallocatechin. The greener and fresher the tea, the higher the antioxidant content, but there are ways to help preserve the antioxidants in products. Resveratrol is another antioxidant that's commonly used in both skincare and nutrition. It's found in grape skins and red wine. Genistein is an isoflavone antioxidant that comes from soy products. Lycopene is a red antioxidant that's found in lots of fruit like tomatoes, watermelons, and apricots. Idebenone is a synthetic variation of coenzyme Q10. Apart from these, there are lots more antioxidants that haven't been tested much yet in clinical trials, but have had good results in vitro and animal studies. It's worth remembering that not all studies are well designed and can be biased, and things that work in vitro and in animal studies might not work on human skin, and a lot of it will depend on the formulation of the product. It's hard to work out exactly which products are going to be effective, because so much depends on the formulation of the product and not just the active ingredients. Some of the factors that need to be considered include whether the antioxidant stays active in the product until you apply it to your skin, whether the antioxidant penetrates the skin and gets to where it needs to be to work, whether enough of the antioxidant penetrates to make a difference. So if you have a lot more free radicals than antioxidants, then it won't make much of a dent in your free radical damage. Unfortunately, there aren't many reliable ways of measuring how antioxidant a particular product is, and there aren't many studies on the effects of different formulations, so it's hard to compare different products. But while we wait for new research, in the meantime, here are some guidelines that should increase your chances of getting an effective product. The antioxidants that have the most evidence to back them up are vitamin C or ascorbic acid, vitamin E, ferulic acid, green tea polyphenols, coenzyme Q10, ubiquinone. These will be your safest bets. Combinations of antioxidants usually work better. They're synergistic and they can help replenish each other. For example, in one study, a combination of 15% vitamin C and 1% vitamin E protected against UV damage twice as much as vitamin C on its own, and adding ferulic acid helped even more. Antioxidants should also be applied before free radicals form, so before you go out into the sun. If you apply it afterwards, the antioxidants won't have time to intercept the free radicals before they attack your body. That's all from me. If you like my videos, I would really appreciate it if you subscribe to my channel. You can also follow my blog, Instagram, and Facebook if you're into beauty science. Bye!